The following is a production of Learfield Sports.
It's football season in Chattanooga, where the Mocs are back-to-back SoCon champions.
We've got baddest football players in this room.
Caught at the 25, down to the 20, down to the 10, touchdown Chattanooga.
Well, I think the fan support part of it is huge, because our fans are phenomenal.
Wants to throw, and it is picked.
Led by head coach Russ Huseman.
Come out and play with unbelievable energy today. Play with a chip on your shoulder today. You guys belong. Let's roll.
Welcome to Inside Chattanooga Football, hosted by head coach Russ Huseman and the voice of the Chattanooga Mocs, Jim Reynolds. Brought to you by Allegra, 24-hour relief from indoor and outdoor allergies. By Coca-Cola, Chattanooga Coca-Cola Bottling Company, the world's largest Coca-Cola bottler. By FSG Bank, proud to be the official bank of Chattanooga Mocs Athletics.
Welcome to Inside Chattanooga Football. I'm Jim Reynolds here at Scrappy Moore Practice Field. On the program today, we're going to take a special look at UTC football, kind of a behind-the-scenes look as we got ready for the game last Saturday, including walking along on the Mocs walk before the game. Obviously, we'll have highlights of the Mocs game with Jacksonville State from last weekend at Finley Stadium, and head coach Russ Huseman will join us as we preview the upcoming game when UTC takes on Mars Hill this coming Saturday afternoon. Also, our Student Athlete of the Week is cross-country runner Rebecca Greenwall. We'll talk with her as she gets ready for the upcoming Powerade Cross-Country Classic. All that and more when Inside Chattanooga Football returns in just a moment.
This segment of Inside Chattanooga Football is brought to you by Allegra, 24-hour relief from indoor and outdoor allergies.
Game week feels like when you wake up on a Tuesday morning, first day of preparation, you get those chills in your body, you start to get those like flies already before the weeks even start. That's what it feels like to me. It's like a very focused, like, the attention from everybody just changes. Everybody just focuses in, and everybody just practices harder, goes harder in everything they do because they want it to be just right and ready for the game. Just starting in practice, making sure we're running around, flying around to the ball, and tackling very well. That's what's going to be the key, is just tackling well at practice and running around, making sure we're always around the ball so when the game time comes, we're ready to go.
I think everybody realizes the type of game this could be with two, in my opinion, two excellent football teams. I think we got a good team. We've got good players. And I think Jacksonville State has a really good football team and really good players and good coaches. And this thing is going to come down to the wire. I got one of those feelings that I think we're both going to play well. And if we both play well, this is going to be decided in the fourth quarter somehow, or overtime, or whatever it is. But two good teams going at it. Respect Jacksonville State and what they've done. I think Coach has done a fantastic job there, taking over that program, and could be one of those epic battles there. You want to win every game, whether it's this game, the next game, the Florida State, whatever it is, you want to win them all. You want to win every game, so it's one of 11. We're going to play hard, and they're all the same to me. We want to win them all, and this just happens to be the one that's up this Saturday. So we're going to play hard and get after them like they're going to get after us too. Yeah, they're really good up front. I think that's where they go. I don't think there's any question. And they've got some talented kids in the secondary. I think they're replacing a couple linebackers. But, you know, they were successful last year because of what they did up front and how physical they were up front. You know, just the – you know, you couldn't get any push up front on these guys. And it was the same – it wasn't just us. It was a lot of teams couldn't get push. They're athletic. They're long. They're big. So I think up front is where it starts for them defensively. You know, with that being said, they do have some really talented secondary guys. So, you know, we're going to have to execute offensively to move the ball on them. But, again, we're a year older. We've got a lot of players back, and, you know, we'll see how it goes.
It's been a long time coming. This, especially for me personally, it's since not sitting out last year and everything. But game week, everybody's tired of hitting everybody from camp and everything, and it's good to have an opponent now, and everybody's got kind of those jitters and everything about them, just ready to actually play the game. Oh, I mean, we kind of threw the guys into a fire last year, having to switch some people around and everything. And they're good up front, but we're coming in hoping that we can match that and just hope for the best.
You see it, like when you go out places downtown, everybody's just like, we need a win this Saturday. We got to have a win. Like, I just left the class, and my teacher pointed at me and Keontae. Was like, you guys are ready? Everybody's asking, are we ready? Are we ready to go? Are we excited about it? But it's a lot more buzz around town than it was last year, for sure.
We celebrate you, loyal UTC fans, who brave sunburn and parking game after game. You super fans who live, eat, and breathe your UTC sports. And you, family of fanatics, passing down your game day traditions. No matter who you are, Mighty Mocs, FSG has you covered. Get the exclusive PowerC debit card and show your UTC pride. Together, we'll ride the rails to victory. FSG Bank is proud to be the official bank of UTC Athletics.
The Learfield Sports Directors Cup honors the nation's best overall collegiate athletic program in each division, men's and women's sports. The prestigious award continues its reign as the crowning achievement in college athletics. To follow your favorite team, like us on Facebook, find us in USA Today, online, and on Twitter at LS Directors Cup. Over two decades of excellence, the Learfield Sports Directors Cup.
This segment of Inside Chattanooga Football is brought to you by Coca-Cola, Chattanooga Coca-Cola Bottling Company, the world's largest Coca-Cola bottler.
I'm Eric Gray, Chattanooga Mocs alumnus.
My name is Adam Stevens. I graduated from University of Tennessee, Chattanooga in May 2014.
I'm Tim Hensley. I have a daughter here that goes to UTC. She's a senior this year.
Drew Holland, class of 2008. Got my master's here in 2011.
My name is Jeff Martin, and this is the Old Mocs Tailgating Crew. We've been out here in the north lot for about 7 years, and then we did it in the pavilion before that, and then we moved out here because our tailgate grew so big we needed the space.
We've been tailgating as part of the Big Shoe Crew for 5 years, but I probably missed five or six home games in the past 25 years.
We call ourselves Fear the Bird. Coach Huseman's first year is when we started. We started with two guys. Now I think we'll have about 40 people here today. So
I've been tailgating as a student for about five years. Before that, I was in the band and I would do a little bit of tailgating, but I always loved it. So when I graduated, I just kept on the tradition, and it's just a lot of fun.
We've been tailgating. In fact, Tyler Spry and I've been tailgating here since 2005 when we both started. It wasn't as exciting then, that the 2-8 and so seasons weren't near as fun as they are now. Of course, we love to see the wins, but we've been out here every year since we were an undergrad. This morning we got up. Tyler and I met here about 8 o'clock in the morning. So you got to get here early if you want your spot.
Well, we make sure we have a TV, especially when the Tennessee game is on. So we'll watch that before we head into the stadium, and we'll watch TV. We got a grill today, plenty of coolers full of cold beer drinks.
Oh, we make everything from jambalaya to hamburgers and hot dogs. Last tailgate of the year, we usually do big steaks and all that kind of thing. We'll do anything. Today we got, if it can have bacon on it, we'll have it. Bacon wrapped shrimp, bacon cheeseburgers. If you can put bacon around it, we're probably going to cook it at some point today. So.
My favorite part of the game day experience, of course, we come here, we want to see the game, we want to see the Mocs win. But I'll tell you, the Moc Walk is something I don't think enough people go to. I love seeing the guys that are actually going to be on the field doing the work. And those are the guys that have been working really hard all year to get ready to this point. So I like to go see the guys and congratulate them and encourage them on the game. So that's the part that I probably like the best.
I just getting out here hanging with the people and getting to pull for the Mocs and getting out here and enjoying cornhole and cooking and seeing everybody have a good time. And
Being out here in this expansive parking lot under the blue sky, we're always seemingly blessed with weather and places to throw ball with the kid and just enjoy people all around the parking lot.
Everybody's really nice. I've been to other schools and tailgated, and you know, it's not always been the best for the away team, but whenever you know you're in Chattanooga, everybody's really humble and really nice, even to people who pass them by from the other team.
I like it all. I like getting here early and staying late. You know, I mean, I like everything about it.
The people. It's like a reunion every game. I mean, everybody's like, I can't wait to get back there. It's just something about it when you get everybody back here and just hugs and high fives. Win or lose, it doesn't matter. I mean, we're here, rain or shine. Go Mocs.
Go Mocs.
Go Mocs. Fear the bird.
Go Mocs.
Go Mocs.
It's time for the Student Athlete Spotlight, brought to you by Southeast Bank.
Runner set.
Hi, I'm Rebecca Greenwall. I'm from Bogart, Georgia, and I'm a senior. Well, I spent my senior year at Baylor School right down the road, and I had a twin sister and we decided we were gonna go in state to Georgia Southern. We had some friends down there and they had a small program, so we thought maybe we could go and work with it and see how it would go. Well, we went down there for a semester and kind of decided it wasn't for us, so we decided we'd come back up to Chattanooga because we love Chattanooga. We knew it was a great school with a great running program, distance program, so we kind of just ended back up here. Well, it was sort of an adjustment at first, always having that consistent training partner, and I kind of just had to learn to run by myself, and I think that was sort of good for me it was a change, but it was good for me, and not having somebody always trying to be competitive with every single run. Well, I'm a nursing major. This is my last semester in nursing school, and I'm not quite sure where I'll end up. I've applied for a few residency programs, and so I'm just kind of waiting to see right now where I get accepted to, and then eventually grad school. For me individually, I kind of went out a little too hard, maybe a little too ambitious. First race of the season, it was hot. But as a team, I think we've got a lot of talent, a lot of potential, and it's still really early in the season. We've got a good course here. We're very familiar with it. It's easy, just 2-lap course for us. It'll be a quick race, and we're kind of really putting a lot into this meet. And then we're going to spend a couple weeks training really hard for our next race in South Carolina.
This segment of Inside Chattanooga Football is brought to you by FSG Bank, proud to be the official bank of Chattanooga Mocs Athletics.
Derek Crane, single setback. Crane gets the call up the middle, goes off tackle, and up to the 40 and 41-yard line, and that'll be a Chattanooga first down. Right man in motion near side. Play action again. To throw over the middle, pass complete, caught at the 30, 25 down to the 20-yard line. Mocs get the big play that time out of the backfield. Rick Cardray Bagley.
A 21-yarder, so he was 5 of 6 on the night.
Snap on the way, kick on the way, plenty of distance, and the kick is good. Mocs on the board, 3-0 lead, Chattanooga. Senior to come. Jenkins takes the snap, pulls it back, rolls out, and hit, and drop. He had time initially, waited an extra second for blue jerseys, blue pants. Jacob Huseman is going to run up the middle, bits it to the 30, and takes out a man and picks up the first down. September in Chattanooga. He'll punt it away and get a good one off. Great hang time. CJ Board goes back, fields it, going backwards at the 30, makes one miss, goes on the near side. He's at the 40, midfield at the 50, at the 40, 35, 30, tripped up at the 25-yard line. Nice return by CJ Board. It took the last man. From Georgia, Hunter Townsend, near side, flip up the middle, and it goes to Derek Crane. I don't know if that developed late into the first quarter. Huseman takes a snap. He's going to keep. He goes up the middle, breaks a tackle, touchdown, Chattanooga. Put it in the gut, pulled it back, saw an opening up the middle. Jacob Huseman, 8 yards, and the Mocs with their first touchdown of the year. That occurs at the 2:02 mark as Jacksonville State Gamecocks going from the gun. Jenkins throws up in the air, pass complete, but I think just short of the stick. Jacob Huseman, 3 wide receivers near side. And it's Jacob up the middle after a nice fake, and he picks up not only 1 yard, but about 10 additional yards after that. Wing position on the left side. Hand off up the middle, little running room, and then stopped and dropped. Shy of the first down. Side, he'll move it in motion. Huseman, option to Derek Crane, gets the pitch, turns it upfield, 30, 35, 40, 45-yard line, nice run. Little option action that time for the Mocs. Gamecocks go three-man front, three rushing. Back the other way to Bagley. Bagley with a blocker in front of him. Gets past one, gets past another, and I think he might have gotten the first down. Derek Crane, single setback, play action. Huseman to throw, has plenty of time. Unloads underneath, pass complete. Thought it might have been picked there for a second, but no, Alfonso Stewart made the catch. 3-yard field goal for Chattanooga to tie. Ribeiro's kick is good, and we're not in the once again. Tie ball game.
90.
Jenkins holds it. Rolls out near side and hit it to backfield. Back at the 19-yard line. Mocs went after him that time, and Trevor Wright got to the quarterback and dropped him. Jenkins, the quarterback, from the gun. Third down, 3 yards to go. Takes the snap. Pope gets the call. Tripped up in the backfield. I'm not sure he didn't trip over his own man, in all honesty. Hit over 100 yards before the first quarter was history. Gets the call right here, hit a couple of times, and Mocs steal it away. Running down the field, down to the 30, 20, 15, 10. Touchdown, Chattanooga, a guy you didn't even know was going to play. Montrell Pardue, redshirt freshman from Clarksville. Stole the football, raced down the field. Mocs have a lead in the fourth quarter. Montrell Pardue, welcome to Mocs football. The redshirt freshman playing the strong safety spot tonight, wrestled it away, reversed the field, sprinted down the numbers on the near part of the field, and into the end zone. And like last year, it took the defense to score some points. Final score from Finley Stadium. Jacksonville State wins it 23-20. 23-20 the final score.
We celebrate you, loyal UTC fans, who brave sunburn and parking game after game. You super fans who live, eat, and breathe your UTC sports. And you, family of fanatics, passing down your game day traditions. No matter who you are, Mighty Mocs, FSG has you covered. Get the exclusive PowerC debit card and show your UTC pride. Together, we'll ride the rails to victory. FSG Bank is proud to be the official bank of UTC Athletics.
Welcome back to Inside Chattanooga Football. I'm Jim Reynolds, along with Mocs head football coach Russ Huseman. All right, what do you work on this week? We'll talk about Jacksonville State in a moment. How do you get better? I know that's all you're worried about right now.
Well, we got to clean up some things. You know, first game, we made some mistakes that we don't normally make, especially defensively, not fitting gaps. We played really hard on defense, but, you know, when you don't fit the right gaps or get us lined up correctly, you know, we got to go back. We got to make sure we fix those things. And then offensively, we got to execute better, no question about that. I thought special teams-wise, our guys did an outstanding job. You know, it was about what I thought coming off the field. They, you know, they made some plays when they had to. We didn't make plays when we had to, and that's the outcome of the game right there.
We talked about these two teams fairly evenly matched as far as team speed, and yet they got some big plays. They got two or three big plays from the running game.
Yeah, I mean, they got a crease inside, and every one of them were like that, you know, where it was just inside and a crease. And, you know, one time was a missed tackle. Another time we didn't fit a gap right. Another time we didn't have the front lined up correctly. And, you know, when you're kind of an eight-man front like we are, and you're going to plug gaps, and we put pressure on the secondary to cover them. And you know, you got to make sure you're where you're supposed to be. But and when it works and it's good, it's good. You know, when you don't fit a gap, you know, there's people all over the place.
Just talk a little bit about some of the things you mentioned a moment ago. Certainly correctable, right?
Yeah, there's a lot, especially defensively. I go back, we played really, really hard. You know, we got after him. We pressured him. We did the things that we wanted to do. But we got to play smarter. I mean, sometimes playing hard, playing fast, is if you don't play smart with it, then big plays can happen. You know, offensively, we got to get better, no question. We got to have some of our better players playing better. We got to feature. We got to get our wide receivers more involved in the game, no question. But they didn't deserve to be involved in the game the way they blocked and some of the things they were doing during the course of that game. Pretty disappointing there. But I think if you start to get them involved in the game a little bit more, maybe, you know, they'll pick it up and do a little bit better. But we didn't get those guys involved like we should, and we will down the road.
Keontae Davis had a good day with eight tackles. We talked about Montrell Pardue making probably the biggest play defensively, but he had seven tackles on the day. He had a good evening, didn't he?
Yeah, for his first time going out there, you know, you're always nervous, but first game, he played really well. Proud of how he played. And then, you know, you mentioned Keontae, just a monster day for him. And some of the things that people don't see, you know, he got the three tags for a loss and a sack and a bunch of tackles. But, you know, he hits the guy multiple times, shoves the offensive tackle into his lap for an incomplete pass. So some of those things people don't see and they don't come out in the stats. But he did a great job and he did everything we expected him to do.
On offense, did Jacob just not have enough time to throw, or overall play not enough time for plays to develop?
Well, in some instances it was that. Other instances, you know, he didn't put it on the wide. You know, we threw the screen out there and he threw it low to Xavier one time. We could have had a play there. And then a 2-minute, you know, he throws it behind him a little bit. You know, and Xavier couldn't hang on to it. But you know, he probably did what we asked him to do during the course of a game. You know, I don't know if there was a time. I guess there was pressure. I mean, they're good up front. I mean, there's no question about that. And we knew we were playing a tough team. That's probably why we only, you know, tried to throw some drop back stuff. It was minimal what we were doing back there. But we got to get better. We got to protect him better too.
And just look ahead to Mars Hill. Where do you want to see the improvement this week?
Well, I want to see us play hard again and get after it and play with relentless effort. But I do want us to make sure that as we're practicing this week, you know, it's unacceptable for them to not know what we're doing defensively and offensively, who we're going at, who we're blocking offensively. They weren't complicated defensively. They weren't complicated offensively. Jacksonville State, I'm talking about. And for us to have the mental mistakes we had after, you know, all the prep we had leading into it. But sometimes, again, it's first game, man. Those things happen. You know, I was pleased. You know, we didn't have a ton of penalties. Or turnovers. And then those things happened in the first game. They didn't happen for us. So, you know, we'll clean up some things and get better as we go.
Mocs and Mars Hill this coming Saturday. That's a 1 o'clock kickoff at Finley Stadium. We'll have highlights of that game next time on Inside Chattanooga Football.
Inside Chattanooga Football has been brought to you by Allegra, 24-hour relief from indoor and outdoor allergies. By Coca-Cola, Chattanooga Coca-Cola Bottling Company, the world's largest Coca-Cola bottler. By FSG Bank, proud to be the official bank of Chattanooga Mocs Athletics.